द रूरल क्रेडिट सर्वे कमेटी विच लुक्ड इंटू द एंटायर क्वेश्चन इन 2001 हैड मेड सर्टेन रिकमेंडेशंस. In the drafting of our plans, the recommendations of the Rural Credit Survey Committee were given due weight. You know that in the 9th five-year plan, it was stated that at least 50% of the villages should be brought under cooperatives. According to the 11th plan, and all the villagers and all the peasants' families are to be brought under cooperatives. This is the perspective with which the Planning Commission has looked at the problem. What prompted them to do that was that in the Rural Credit Survey Committee's report, they have said that both through the government and cooperative sources, credits were available to peasants only to the tune of 6%. Through cooperatives alone, it is, I think, 3% or so. The other sources of credit to the peasants are the original money lenders. They have elaborately described all that. One point which they stressed in their report is that even the cooperatives do not cater to the needs of the weaker sections of the village community. They have stated that in villages where the money lender, the trader, and the village chief function through one person, even the cooperative movement is controlled by them in many places. If they are outside the cooperative movement, they will sabotage it from outside. If they are in control of it, they will sabotage it from within. So even the 3% credit which had gone to the peasantry in the name of the cooperative movement did not reach them really. So they made it a point in their report to stress that in future we should see that the credit really goes to the weaker sections of the village community. Now, sir, after the report of the Rural Credit Survey Committee, we have been working for the last few years. I do not think that a proper evaluation has yet been made as to how the present day cooperative societies are working. As far as extending the facilities to a larger section of the rural population is concerned, the cooperative movement has succeeded. My point is whether this emphasis that the committee had laid on taking special care to see that these facilities reach all the lower section has been properly worked out. Another point is that even in the matter of extending the activities of the cooperatives, we have not reached the target which was fixed in any of the plans. Now, they want to make it universal, but even during the 9th five-year plan or even during the 10th five-year plan, the target that was placed before the country was not reached. It was estimated that rupees 2000 crores are needed for agricultural operations every year, of which rupees 800 crores would be financed from their own earnings. द अदर रुपीज 1200 crores दे हैव टू गेट आइदर थ्रू कोऑपरेटिव्स और थ्रू अदर एजेंसीज एंड दिस इज नीडेड फॉर देयर शॉर्ट टर्म मीडियम टर्म एंड लॉन्ग टर्म लोन्स. फॉर ऑल दिस ऑफकोर्स द कोऑपरेटिव डिपार्टमेंट हैव मेड सर्टेन प्लान्स एंड दे हैव मेड सर्टेन स्टडीज अंडर द लीडरशिप ऑफ द वी एल मेहता कमेटी एंड दे हैव रियली मेड सर्टेन कंक्रीट एंड हेल्पफुल सजेशंस टू इम्प्रूव द वर्किंग ऑफ दीज कोऑपरेटिव्स. बट इवन हेयर In spite of all the recommendations, in spite of all the studies, things are not working in the proper direction. Now, apart from these credit facilities, much has been said here about the processing factors like sugar factories, etc., which should go to help the peasants. I fully agree that apart from credit societies, marketing societies, processing societies, all these put together will be of great help to the peasants. But are they really serving the real agriculturists? I have heard some people speaking about the successful functioning of certain cooperative societies. I know one cooperative sugar factory. Among its members, not even 1% are actual agriculturists. Just like a joint stock company, shares are sold, capital is raised, and they are running a proper factory. My point is that such factories should not be brought within the purview of the cooperative movement. They should be treated as ordinary joint stock companies. I will quote another example which is to be followed, and that is the Weavers Society. There they have made it a point that among its members at least 80% or 90% should be weavers themselves. They have made that a strict rule. If that is so, if such principles are accepted and adhered to, then these processing societies will be of immense help to the peasants. Otherwise, in the name of helping the peasants, some people skip the other obligations that may accrue from running a joint stock company and are taking the benefit. I do not feel it proper to invest money in large scale enterprises on a cooperative basis.